You know how in Cosmos, Carl Sagan talks about other dimensions, like beyond our world?
Yeah, sure. Theoretically.
Right, theoretically. So, theoretically, how do we travel there?
You guys have been thinking about Hugh Everett's many worlds interpretation, haven't you? Well, basically, there are parallel universes, just like our world, but just infinite variations of it. Which means there's a world out there where none of this tragic stuff ever happened.
Yeah, that's not what we're talking about.
Oh.
We were thinking of more of an evil dimension, like the Veil of Shadows. You know the Veil of Shadows?
Echo of the material plane where necrotic and shadow magic.
Yeah, exactly. If that did exist, a place like the Veil of Shadows, how would we travel there,
theoretically?
Well, picture an acrobat standing on a tightrope. Now, the tightrope is our dimension, and our dimension has rules. You can move forwards or backwards. But what if, right next to our acrobat, there is a flea? Now, the flea can also travel back and forth, just like the acrobat, right?
Right.
Yeah. Here's where things get really interesting. The flea can also travel this way, along the side of the rope. He can even go underneath the rope.
Upside down.
Exactly.
But we're not the flea, we're the acrobat.
In this metaphor, yes, we're the acrobat.
So we can't go upside down?
No.
Well, is there any way for the acrobat to get to the upside down?
Well, you'd have to create a massive amount of energy, more than humans are currently capable of creating, mind you, to open up some kind of tear in time and space. And then, you create a doorway.
Like a gate?
Sure, like a gate. But again, this is all
theoretical.
But what if this gate already existed?
Well, if it did, I think we'd know. It would disrupt gravity, the magnetic field, our environment. Heck, it might even swallow us up whole. Science is neat, but I'm afraid it's not very forgiving.